Hello, welcome to my channel. It is very easy to prepare your tax return. In this video, I'm going to show you how to use UFile online to prepare your tax return. There are many CRA certified software. Some are free, some are not. You can choose the one that best meets your needs. I always start by reviewing my notice of assessment from the prior year to see if I have any carry forward amount. For example, LRSP contribution limit and just the tuition amount. In addition to T3, T4, T5, you may also have receipt for medical expenses, donations, home office expenses, etc. It is very important to keep all of your supporting documents for at least 6 years.
The first step is to log into UFile online. If you don't have an account, you will have to create a new account. After you log into UFile, you can create a new file for the 2024 tax year. I already created the file, so I'm just going to click Launch to open the 2024 tax file. You can use the navigation panel on the left to go to different pages. The first page is for the identification information. Enter your name, social insurance number, date of birth. The net file access code is an 8-character code located on your notice of assessment for the previous tax year. It is intended to be used as an extra level of security. If this is the first time you file your tax return, you don't have to enter this. This is optional. Enter your province or territory of residence on December 31st, 2024. Your marital status, whether your status has changed in 2024, your gender, and click Next. For the information for the spouse, usually we put incomplete information. Unless for special situations, for example, if the spouse is a non-resident who doesn't have to file a tax return, then we can select net income only. For this example, I'm going to choose complete information. Click Next. Put in your mailing address. If you moved it in 2024 from one province or territory to another, you have to put in the date of your move. Confirm whether your home address is the same as your mailing address. And put in your telephone number. Click Next. Answer some mandatory CRA questions. The language of the tax return. Are you filing the tax return for the very first time? Did you own any specified foreign property in 2024 with a total cost over $100,000? If your answer to this question is yes or you're not sure, you should consult with a professional. This is because the rules for foreign property T1135 reporting are very complex. Did you sell a principal residence in 2024? Answer all the questions on this page. For the purpose of the Canada carbon rebate, we have to specify the area we live in. For the email notifications from the CRA, if you prefer to receive your notifications and documents through email, you can select Yes and put in your email address. Do you have a foreign mailing address on file with the CRA? After you answer all the questions, click Next. Will you be using NetFile to submit your federal return electronically? This means, do you want to file your tax return electronically to the CRA? I'm going to choose yes if eligible. Will you be using NetFile to submit a prior year federal return today or within the next 2 days? I'm going to choose no. If you intend to file your prior year's return, please file your returns in order, meaning the oldest return first. This is because any prior year amount could potentially impact your current year amount. Click Next. For the CRA autofill my return, if you have a CRA My Account, this optional function allows you to download into UFile the information that the CRA has available so that you don't have to enter some of the information manually. If you are using this function, it is still important to check the information with your supporting documents. The CRA does not have all the information, such as medical expenses, home office expenses, etc. You still have to enter those manually. With the Express Notice of Assessment, you can get your Notice of Assessment right after you file your tax return. You must be registered with the CRA My Account in order to use the Express NOA. Next, we'll complete the interview setup. Check all the boxes that are relevant for you. It is important to recognize that the residency status for income tax purposes is not the same as residency status for immigration purposes. If you become a resident of Canada for income tax purposes in 2024, you need to enter your date of entry and your income earned while you were a non-resident. The income earned as a non-resident before moving to Canada is non-taxable, except for income you received it from Canadian source. Income earned as a non-resident is required to calculate certain benefits and credits. If you're not sure about your residency status for income tax purposes, you should consult the CRA or consult with a professional. Once you have checked all the boxes that are relevant for you, click Next. The navigation panel on the left has been updated to show the pages that you just selected. We'll go to T4 and Employment Income and click on the plus icon next to the T4 income to enter the information on your T4. You will need to enter all the information as per your T4 tax slip. Once you are done entering all the information, double check the information just to make sure you enter everything correctly. Then you can click Next. If you have more than one T4, you can go back to the T4 and Employment Income section and click on the plus icon to open a new page to enter the information from your other T4 tax slip. Next, I work from home in 2024, and I met the CRA criteria for using the detailed method to claim home office expenses. We'll go to the Employment Expenses section. Choose the option that is relevant for you. For this example, I'm going to use the T777 Eligible Employment Expenses for an employee earning a salary. Remember, you need supporting documents and a signed T2200 from your employer. Enter the information for your employer and enter your information as well. Then go to the Home Office Expenses page and enter all the relevant information. To calculate the percentage of your home being used for employment purposes, use a reasonable basis. Once you've entered all the relevant information, click Next. If your employer has already completed Form T2200 for you do not need to fill it out here. You do not have to submit Form T2200 with your tax return. However, the CRA may ask to see it later. Next, we'll look at interest and investment income. Click on the plus icon to open a page to enter the information based on your tax slip. For the T5, if it is a joint account, then you have to put in the percentage you're entitled to. For this example, I'm going to assume I earned interest income. Interest income is reported in box 13. Once you're done entering all the information on your tax slip, click Next. We'll look at RRSP. For the RRSP, you have to enter your RRSP deduction limit for 2024. You can find this information on your 2023 notice of assessment. Enter your deduction limit and contributions. You can choose whether to use all of your RRSP deduction in the current year, or save all or some to future years. Click Next. Next, we'll look at donations. Go to the Donations Political Contributions page. Choose the type of donations that are relevant for you. Enter the organization name and the donation amount. Specify the nature of the donation. Click Next. For the medical expenses, we need to enter the date and also a description of the medical expenses. I purchased a pair of glasses for $500 on June 1st, 2024. If you have more than one medical expense, you can click on the plus icon and enter the information from all of your receipts. Click Next. For medical expenses, to qualify for the tax credit, your medical expenses must be more than the lesser of 3% of your 2024 net income, or $2,759. If you're not sure, you can enter all of your expenses into the software. The software will determine whether you're eligible for the medical expense tax credit. Next, we'll look at tuition. Enter the information based on your T2202. You can find your unused tuition amount from prior years on your previous year's notice of assessment and in your CRA My Account. If you have a spouse or common law partner and you would like to prepare your tax returns together, you can add a spouse or common law partner. The questions are basically the same, such as identification, address, CRA questions, etc. If you have dependents, you can add a dependent by clicking on the Add Dependent icon and just follow the instructions and answer all the questions. Once you are done entering all the information, you can click Review in order to review the information. The software calculates the refund or balance owing. It is a good habit to review the errors, warnings, and information section. You can also look at the tax savings ideas to see if there are any tax savings recommendations that may be relevant for you. You can go to the Federal Summary tab in order to see the summary of the tax information. After you review the information, you can go to the tax return page to download a copy of the PDF file for your records. When you are ready to file your tax return, you can go to the net file page to file your tax returns. You'll get a confirmation number from the CRA for each tax return. Please keep this for your record. Thank you so much for watching. If you like my video, please subscribe, like, and share. See you next time.